What up, guys, and welcome back to TV Time with Jay, and I am back once again for another review for you guys, and this time I'm here to review the new FX on Hulu original series, A Teacher, which is going to be a miniseries starring Kate Mara and the actor who played Simon from Love, Simon. So, as per usual, with my episode reviews, I will be recapping the events of all three of the first episodes of this premiere, because they dropped the first three episodes, and it's going to be weekly from then on. I think it's going to be a 10-episode miniseries, so this is going to be fun to talk about, even though it's also really uncomfortable. But anyway, I will be covering basically, you know, an overall plot summary as well as my thoughts on all three of these premiere episodes. So if you have not seen these three episodes yet, do yourself a favor, watch the episodes first, then come back here and tell me your thoughts and feels in the comments down below, because I will be going into spoiler territory. You have been warned. Okay, as the title of the miniseries implies, A Teacher is about a teacher played by Kate Mara, Claire Wilson, who ends up getting in a relationship with one of her students, named Eric, played by the actor who played Simon from Love, Simon. And, of course, it's always the English teacher. It's either going to be the English teacher or the art teacher. Now, one thing that I do appreciate about this show is that they are definitely making it clear that Claire, the female teacher, is the predator in this situation. Because one thing that I've always hated about these, student-teacher stories is that, you know, they always completely crucify the male whenever it's a male teacher preying on a female student, which obviously they should, but whenever it's a female teacher who ends up getting in a relationship with a male student, you know, people, and in particular other dudes, are like, oh, where were these teachers when I was growing up? And I get it, right? You're thinking with your, like, male adult brain, and, like, you know, it's like, wait, you know, I didn't actually think about the fact that, you know, I would have been a child and this adult woman would have been taking advantage of me and making me feel special and, you know, preying on me in the same way that male teachers would prey on female students. So I'm glad that, you know, they're shining a light on this double standard, because let me tell you, man, Kate Mara in these three episodes comes off super creepy, in my opinion. Maybe because I was, like, specifically looking for it. I've seen a couple people talk about it, you know, within, like, the first, you know, because it's only been out a day as of recording this video. I've seen a couple people talk about it, saying that, like, you know, they're showing it as kind of a romance. Don't really see that. I definitely see that she's singling him out. She's making him feel special. She's, like, going to a party with him where there's alcohol and people drinking, and she's, like, doing these subtle little encouragements, and she tries to play it off like, you know, she's not interested in him, and she's like, you know, you need to leave now when he tries to kiss her in episode 3. But by the end in episode 3, she literally takes him in her car to a secluded area, and she's like, you know, we don't have to do this if you don't want to. And all he does, like, is say, no, I want to. She doesn't hesitate a second after that. She's like, all right, get in the back seat. Oh my god, yo, Kate Mara just in this series is just like full-on predator. Now, again, I'm not gonna make excuses for her, or for her character, but, you know, her husband is, of course, like, this just, you know, man-child, doesn't really take her seriously, doesn't, you know, listen to her in any of her decisions, and also, it seems like the way they're framing it is that she was kind of robbed of her own adolescence, because she had to kind of be an adult and take care of her father, and not really have any of the normal teenage to college experiences. So she's kind of getting this through Eric, which, again, is wrong and a total abuse of power that I do not condone whatsoever. But, again, I like that they're at least, you know, showing her reasoning behind it. But, man, it's so refreshing to actually see that, you know, they're pointing out that, yeah, this chick is a fucking predator. And, I mean, they made it pretty clear in the previews that, like, you know, they are framing her as a predator, as someone who is targeting these young, still impressionable young men, or at least, you know, in this case, a young, impressionable young man who, you know, yeah, sure, he's 18, but, dude, you're his teacher, and he is in high school. Now, of course, I would still kind of look down upon, like, a teacher-student relationship between, like, a 25-year-old and a 30-year-old college professor, but at least in that regard, yeah, it's still an abuse of power, and it's still wrong, but at least, you know, you're both adults in the situation, so there's a little bit more room to talk there. Still wrong because it's an abuse of power, but this time, like, it's a kid. He's 18. I do also, like, you know, another positive I want to talk about is, like, this is set in 2013, which was actually, like, well, actually, no, that wasn't my, that was my freshman year of college. No, it was my sophomore year of college. I can't count. I started college in 2013. Yeah, I'm stupid. I can't count. Yeah, so that was my freshman year of college. So I was actually relatively around this kid's age when this is taking place, because he's a senior in high school in 2013. I graduated in 2012. I like that, you know, all the different, like, UIs that they show, like the iMessage UI, the Instagram UI, Snapchat, all that, it looks like it did in 2013. It's pretty authentic. The music that they play was all shit that was, you know, popping in 2013. So again, pretty accurate to the times. I really appreciate that. Although it feels kind of weird to look back at 2013, like, man, that was such a long time ago. But when you really think about it, it was like almost like 5-6 years ago now. Like, it is pretty crazy. No, it's like 7 years ago. I really can't count. I ignore all my bad math. I think so far this show has done a great job with these three episodes of hooking people in. Again, it really does paint Kate Mara as a predator and Eric as a victim. You know, Claire as a predator and Eric as a victim, at least in my opinion. And I do appreciate that. Again, I love seeing these double standards that are usually portrayed by media being broken in shows like this. And, you know, showing that, like, this kid is being clearly taken advantage of. Like, yes, he is also making choices, and this is technically consensual, but is it really? Because he's a kid. You are a grown-ass woman, and he is a kid. And he is a kid under your direct influence because you're helping him. You're, you know, helping him with school and stuff. He opens up to you. He trusts you. Yeah, no, this is complete and total abuse of power. It's gross. It's disgusting. And, you know, listening to interviews and reading interviews with Kate Mara, she talked about how, like, this role really messed her up because she felt personally disgusted and sickened by it, which honestly she should, because, like, yeah, this character's kind of fucked up. And, you know, I appreciate her, like, her skill in being able to just pull that off. It's pretty phenomenal. I really like it. I'm digging this series so far. I am looking forward to covering the rest of it. But let me know what you guys thought about the A Teacher series premiere in the comments down below. If this review got you interested, are you going to check it out? Even though I pretty much spoiled everything for the first three, but are you going to check it out? What did you think about it? What are your thoughts on this whole, like, teacher-student relationship, you know, situation, and, like, the double standards of teacher-student relationships? Let me know all those thoughts and feels in the comments down below. As always, don't forget to leave this video a like to let me know you enjoyed it. And if you like what I do here and you want to see more from me, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. I review a bunch of other great TV shows as well. The fall TV season has really started kicking off. I will leave linked in the outro card my latest review so you can get a feel for what I have to offer here on the channel, as well as a video YouTube and series algorithm thinks you might like, which I hope you do. But until next time, guys, this is Jay from TV Time with Jay, and I'll hopefully catch you guys in the next review. Class dismissed. Peace.